attempts were foiled by an iPad as being linked to another home invasion and sexual assault. Omaha police arrested 32-year-old Ronnie Perry earlier this month. The victim told us how his iPad's webcam showed Perry breaking into an apartment. Now investigators say Perry's responsible for a sexual assault 7 months ago. KETV News Watch 7's Christina Engdahl joins us live with the latest. Christina?
And Rob, police say three people forced their way into a Metro apartment last May, one of them sexually assaulting a woman in her own bedroom. Two of those suspects got away unidentified until now.
Police say when Ronnie Perry broke into this apartment, an iPad app helped them make an arrest. The owner showed it to Newswatch 7.
It's called a baby monitor 3G, so it's intended for babies, but it also works for your dogs, too.
But on January 3rd, Anthony didn't see his dog. He saw an intruder and called police. Moments later, police arrested Perry outside the Cambridge apartments on 96th and Q and checked his background.
It turns out he was a suspect in a home invasion and sexual assault that occurred back in May.
A break in another case, a home invasion at this apartment complex on 49th and Mayberry. According to police reports from that night, one victim says he had a gun held to his head, while a second suspect went to the bedroom with his girlfriend. That's where the second victim, a woman, said she was sexually assaulted. Now police say they've linked Perry to that assault.
They're still gathering information, and they're still following up on that information, and sometimes that does lead to an arrest, even if it's months or years later.
Now Perry's charged with two counts of home invasion and one count of sexual assault, all felonies. Police were also able to identify his brother, Danielle Taliaferro, as the gunman from that night.
Even if some of these investigations seem to go cold, they're never truly cold.
Tuesday, Perry was bound over to district court on charges from this month's burglary. No word from the county attorney if they'll pursue a separate trial from the charges from May. But the third suspect in that case, Christy Hughes, was arrested on the scene. Reporting live, Christina Engdahl, KETV, Newswatch 7. Thanks.